Good genes in practice. That's what we're going to get to. The celebrity photographer who's captured faces of famous people for years now has compiled some of his favorite moments in a new book. The book is called We All Want Something Beautiful. Randall Slavin is here. Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Happy congratulations.
Happy Thanksgiving to all of you.
We have the montage, and then we will get into the individual things. Is there anybody you feel you haven't shot at this point?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I would love to shoot Barack Obama.
Okay.
I have not. So if any of you guys can make that happen, put some calls out there.
How does one become a celebrity photographer?
Well, I don't know, but I think you just sort of, I mean, I was lucky enough that all my friends were actors and we were all struggling actors and we were all sort of trying to make something, and I was just taking pictures of them and they turned into legends. And
then the distinction between what you're doing behind the camera and what they're doing in front of the camera, if you were to sort of formulate an equation, is it 50-50 or is it more important what they do or the way you
frame
it?
Well, you can only shoot what's in front of you. You know, so I'm lucky enough to get to work with people like Mark Wahlberg and Charlize Theron. That certainly helps, but like, that helps a lot.
Right.
let's be honest. That helps a lot.
Right.
Do they know what to do immediately, or do you ever have to coach them a little bit?
Well, everybody likes to be directed, but you know, you get someone who's been there long enough and is at that level. They've done it a lot. They know what they do, and they make it a lot easier.
Is there a distinction now, because we have the phones, everybody's a photographer, is there a difference between, you know, what an amateur gets off their camera phone versus we're going to show some pictures from your 35 millimeter collection from, you know, a quote-unquote real camera?
But equipment doesn't matter. Okay. Equipment doesn't mean a thing. It's about when you push that button and when you capture that moment. Mm-hmm. But, you know, the equipment doesn't mean anything, because you can take incredible pictures on an iPhone or a, you know, a giant Nikon.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, that's interesting. All right, here comes Jennifer Aniston and Adam Derwitz, I believe. There we go. All right, they look cuddly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we were, you know, Friends had just broken huge, and Adam's band was huge, and I think it was 95 this picture was taken. And we were just hanging out at a house that he ended up immortalizing in the song Long December. He says, I drove up to Hillside Manor. Mm-hmm. And that was this house on Hillside that our friends lived at.
Wow.
It was one of those magical summers where we all like hung out at one house.
Right.
And, you know, things you do in your 20s.
Michael J. Fox photo here. And is it from the inside out or the outside in terms of people's appearance? That's a great picture.
That's a cool picture.
Let me tell you something. You don't know love until you walk down the New York streets with Michael J.
Really?
Fox. Oh, my God.
People just go crazy
just
for him.
Shouting and loving. I mean, that guy is so adored, and rightfully so.
Yes, absolutely.
He's the kindest. He's everything you want him to be.
Yeah.
Was this a posed photo? Or did
I see.
Because that's
so
cool.
When he's...
Yeah,
when
if
he's,
it's not, I'm really creepy.
When somebody's posing, are you saying chin to the right?
A little bit.
All right.
How should we pose?
Yes.
It's so funny because, like Sam said with the iPhone, some people are... You see all these people that are bloggers or whatever, and they just look so... And the rest of us...
You know, like,
look
photos used to be... proof. They used to say, if there's a photo, it's proof.
And right.
That is gone. So if you see pictures, never trust that that's actually how they look.
Right.
You know, so that idea of photos being proof doesn't exist. Like, if I take a picture of someone, it goes through numerous process before it ever gets seen.
Well, that makes it feel better then.
See, I have to do in order to get a good picture of smile, I have to do this creepy laugh. Like, I gotta...
Yes.
And he actually agreed it was creepy.
Right. Yeah. But everybody does.
Okay.
Oh, they do something.
Everybody does.
Oh, okay.
The book is We All Want Something Beautiful. There it is. It really, really something great to look at. It is out now. Randall Slavin, thank you so much.
Randall.
Hey, my pleasure,
Sam. Thanks so much.
Happy Thanksgiving, guys.
You too.